Analysis now from Tom Friedman, the Pulitzer Prize-winning foreign policy columnist from the New York Times. Tom, thanks for joining us this morning. You just heard Secretary of State Tillerson there. No change in the United States military strategy towards Syria. I guess the big question is, what is the strategy right now?
Well, what I heard, George, are basically three messages. One is that the Trump people feel that in launching this cruise missile attack in retaliation for Assad's use of chemical weapons, that they've reduced the chances that Assad will use such chemical weapons again or that somebody else will. That's not an unimportant thing. I think they also feel they've increased the uncertainty in places like North Korea as to whether the U.S. will use force if the North Koreans cross that red line on intercontinental ballistic missiles. But what I think he also made clear was that right now, this administration is not interested in going any further than the Obama team did in terms of actually changing the balance of power on the ground between the opposition forces, the pro-American opposition forces there, the Assad regime, and the Russians and Iranians who are backing them. And, you know, without that, it's hard to see any long-term change right now, but it's still early in the process.
Yeah, and the question is what kind of leverage you can use with Russia to get them to pull away from Assad. That doesn't appear to be happening right now. I was struck by something King Abdullah said to Lally Weymouth of The Washington Post this morning. He suggested that the United States should consider concessions on Crimea to cleave Putin away from Assad. Good idea?
I would really think twice about that. You know, I think these two theaters are very different. I mean, it would obviously depend on what Assad was, what Putin was ready to do in Syria, whether he was really ready to break the alliance with the Iranians and create a process by which you're easing Assad out of power and really partner with the world community in creating a different kind of political structure in Syria. If he's ready to go that far, well, you could certainly think about it. But I'd be very careful about that.
How do you make sense of the president's pretty dramatic turnaround this week? Your colleague in the New York Times, Peter Baker, called it a highly improvisational, situational approach towards foreign policy. You know, just last week we saw Secretary Tillerson talking about the Syrian people making the decision on Assad. We saw President Trump all through the campaign saying we can't get involved in this fight. Real change this week.
Well, you know, George, in fairness, Syria is the problem from hell. You know, it's such a fragmented situation on the ground right now. You know, what I saw in Secretary Tillerson there talking about it is, you know, why don't I raise my hand to be Secretary of Agriculture, not Secretary of State? Because it's really a difficult, difficult situation. So the real question is, I think, is two things, George. One is, can we increase our leverage there without putting American troops on the ground by maybe giving more aid to the opposition forces there, considering a no-fly zone? I mean, that's a big NATO-wide question. You know, one thing I'm asking myself today is, where's Trump's Twitter feed when we need it? If I were Trump right now, I'd be hammering Putin on the fact, and the Iranians, that you are a protector of someone using poison gas. Putin, you were either feckless and didn't know your ally was doing this, or you're complicit. And I don't think these guys like to be actually called protectors of someone using poison gas. So I would be doing everything I could on every front to increase our leverage. Because in the Middle East, if you're trying to do diplomacy without leverage, you're playing baseball without a bat.
And we'll see if Secretary Tillerson brings that message to Lavrov this week in Moscow. I wonder if you look, though, also at all the events this week. Steve Bannon off the National Security Council, McMaster asserting himself as the National Security Advisor. You have Secretary Tillerson in that interview right there. Fairly tough talk on Russia. Completely dismissed the idea of Mexico paying for the wall. General Mattis at the heart of these discussions on Syria. Are we seeing these outsiders assert themselves?
Yeah, I think we're seeing a reversion to the mean. You're seeing a reversion to sort of closer to the natural interests of American foreign policy and to the limits of what the American people are really ready to do and tolerate right now. You know, my friend Michael Mandelbaum said to me the other day that, you know, the biggest restraint on American intervention in Syria is democracy in America. The fact that there's just a lot of Americans, and we see this in the Congress, that are wary of getting involved. So I think all that crazy rhetoric from the campaign, you saw it on the paying for the wall in Mexico, that will gradually be muffled out and faded away from.
Tom Friedman, thanks for joining us this morning.
Thanks, George.